Greetings, my friends. I want to thank you all for subscribing. I want to thank all of my channel members for supporting me in this endeavor to save pop culture. And if you are not subscribed, please consider supporting this channel. We need you. Thank you. Greetings, my friends. I am Dictor Van Doomcock, the future ruler of Earth, and I am here today to share some particularly juicy information my Hollywood spies have gathered on just how awful things are right now inside Lucasfilm. This information came out of an interview with a Lucasfilm insider who wanted to get some things off their chest in regard to the Lucasfilm Civil War and Kathleen Kennedy in particular. This is a new individual who has not spoken to us before, who was introduced to us by another Lucasfilm employee who had spoken to us previously, and this interview contains both new information and information that confirms other rumors we've shared in the past. Things are bad at Lucasfilm if what you're about to hear is true, but at this point I must point out that what I'm about to share is information provided to me from a third party claiming to have knowledge of what's going on behind the scenes at Lucasfilm. But since I cannot independently verify any of what I've been told, I cannot report this as anything but mere rumor, and I ask you to consider it as such and to take all of it with several grains of salt. One thing I'd like to get out of the way right at the start is a very persistent rumor that I've heard from many different sources, a rumor that the Favreau camp is in possession of a smoking gun that implicates the Kennedy camp in orchestrating the firing of Gina Carano. From what I understand, if this is true, it would be very damaging to Kennedy since it would be firm evidence of an employee of a company working against the interests of the company. A very serious corporate sin, if my understanding of this is tracking. I'm told the Kennedy stock at Disney is very low at the moment, with the underwhelming performance of the much ballyhooed High Republic skew and the active mockery of Geode by fans who didn't buy Pet Rocks in the 70s and aren't buying this garbage now. And I'm informed this evidence may be the straw that finally breaks the camel's back. If I get more details regarding this alleged smoking gun, I will report on it in a future video, but for now, just log this as another rumor, albeit a persistent one that has been kicking around ever since Gina got fired. And now, on to the interview. Regarding the firing of Gina Carano, this source said, quote, "I knew this was coming, but it was the way it went down. There are a hell of a lot of people that this either scared or made them stand up and take notice. You see, everyone, and I do mean everyone in this place, has something that could get them fired or canceled, as they say. And trust me when I say, it's more than you know. Hollywood made the beast, and now they can't control it, and that scares them more than you know." Unquote. My agent who conducted the interview asked, quote, "Is it as bad as we've been told as far as the fallout with the fans?" Unquote. The source replied, quote, "It's bad. The fact John decided to delay Mandalorian Season 3 until 2023 has Disney in full panic mode, and WandaVision didn't do anywhere near as good as Disney wanted. Then there's the Falcon and Winter Soldier, and it's doing really bad. And then there's the cash cow, the parks. Disney doesn't want to open them too soon, and they can't come to an agreement on capacity. They are scared beyond belief that if one person comes in healthy and leaves sick, and can somehow link it to going to their park, the fallout would be devastating." Unquote. I think all of us knew that things were bad for Disney in terms of its theme park, so none of this was a surprise. Although the confirmation of how bad things are on Disney Plus in terms of the Marvel TV shows is illuminating, if true. Last week I reported a rumor that the wokeness of the Falcon and the Winter Soldier had driven a majority of viewers to bail out of Episode 2 at roughly the same point, around the time when the wokeness became unbearable on that show. Now I'm hearing from a separate source a rumor that Falcon and the Winter Soldier has rebounded slightly in the ratings, up around 20% from earlier episodes, and I'm informed the Disney Plus subscriber base is roughly at 87 million, although this figure does include all those who are free users not currently paying for the service. But Disney Plus alone is not going to float the company long term. And this figure is vastly reduced from the number of subscribers they had after the return of Luke Skywalker and the firing of Gina Carano. That said, returning to the interview, my agent asked this source, quote, "Why does it seem Kathleen Kennedy's camp is so volatile?" unquote. The source replied, quote, "Because it's a bunch of women trying to get over on one another to get Kathy's approval. They think if they prove their worth or show they are special, they can get a leg up to getting a promotion," unquote. So basically, the Kennedy camp is stocked with a bunch of yes women falling all over each other to outwoke their competition to get attention from Kennedy. Not a very sound business strategy, but perhaps Disney doesn't need to worry about money anymore. Maybe they found a chest full of gold doubloons in the Pirates of the Caribbean ride that they had previously assumed were plastic. Mistakes like that happen. It is only a corporation after all. But this is more confirmation that integrity of storytelling and excellence of craft are not primary concerns under Kennedy, which explains why Star Wars projects helmed by Kennedy and her cohorts have sucked harder than Linda Lovelace's vacuum cleaner. Of Kennedy herself, and how she saw the Star Wars universe going under her control, this source replied, quote, "She thought she would be queen of movies and go down as the greatest person in film of all time. That's the simple version," unquote. This also is in line with another source who claimed Kennedy had intended to be so successful with Star Wars, she would be able to eclipse Lucas and ultimately claim Star Wars as her own. Even retroactively claiming Star Wars was her idea all along, but she was held back by the patriarchy and the boys club, who stole credit for her brilliant ideas. My agent expressed skepticism that the media would play along with such an insane retcon of history, but the source disagreed. Quote, "Are you familiar with the term my truth? Do you know what it really means, or better yet, why it's said? Because surely there is only truth. But you have to understand, my truth is something I repeat over and over again till it's accepted as the truth. And as far as the media is concerned, believe me, they would have carried that water," unquote. So this is the first time I've ever heard the phrase my truth, and it makes a lot of sense. If truth is relative, then simply asserting lies as my truth is a tool that can allow individuals and corporations to be in denial of harsh realities, such as the Star Wars brand has been run into the ground and will never again be the potent force it was before Lucas sold it. When all truth is relative, you can no longer assume the truth as a baseline, and that's when you can gaslight fans who complain about the abysmal quality of the sequel trilogy with a straight face. The sequel trilogy didn't suck. It was brilliant and successful and oh so woke, and the declining box office and defecting fans? Well, that's not Kathleen Kennedy's truth. In Kathleen Kennedy's truth, the downward spiral of box office grosses is fake news. Truth is mostly incompatible with wokeness, and thus it is truth itself that must be canceled. When asked, does Kathleen Kennedy hate the fans, this source replied, quote, "Maybe a few years ago. Now hate doesn't even come close," unquote. Which leads us to the failure of the High Republic, something that has not endeared fans to Kennedy, in particular fans who laughed their ass off at making a straight-up rock a High Republic character. My agent posed the question, quote, "Is anyone reading these books before they are released? A rock? They were okay with a rock? Really?" unquote. After laughing, the source replied, quote, "I never said they were okay with anything that comes from that writer's group. The people that are pushing them out have their marching orders. They are to spell check and make sure the art is correct and the book has the right number of pages. Simple stuff like that." So, things like narrative coherence, plausibility, quality, passion, craft, these things mean nothing to the Lucasfilm Story Group or those who are tasked with monitoring their output. All they're supposed to do is just make sure that the rock looks like a rock, that the things are spelled correctly, and they are not missing pages. Well, that explains an awful lot, doesn't it? This source had more to say specifically regarding Kennedy's antipathy towards John Favreau and the exact incident that allegedly triggered that antipathy, and I will be releasing that information and more in a second video next week, but I can tell you, my friends, it's some juicy stuff. From the center of the earth, this is Dichter Van Doomcock bidding you all, my friends, stay angry. Ha 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 ha